Members of this academy and distinguished guests, welcome to the induction of the academy's 233rd class of fellows and foreign honorary members. We are honored to have all of you here for this occasion. From its beginning, the American Academy has convened public servants, bankers, businessmen, physicians, farmers, theologians, and academics to address the issues of the day. In each generation, our fellowship has brought together thinkers and doers, as John Adams called them, people who advance scholarship and innovation, and individuals who serve as the leaders of America's institutions. The members we are about to induct follow in this noble tradition. All of you are leaders and innovators in your fields. Like those before you, your intellect, creativity, and commitment will, I know, enrich the work of the Academy and the world we live in. I am now retiring as chair of the Academy's board. I've been a fellow for 55 years. Let me now have the honor to introduce our newly elected new chair of the board, Don Michael Randall. Don is a musicologist, past provost of Cornell University, past president of both the University of Chicago, and most recently, the Andrew Mellon Foundation. He has long been a strong supporter of the Academy. As a man of knowledge and evidence-based action, as a thinker and a doer, Don Randall is an ideal person to lead us forward. It is my great pleasure to formally welcome you and invite you to open this induction ceremony. Thank you, Don.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Louis. I want, first of all, to say welcome to all of you to this academy, and to thank you for the work that you have done and the distinction you bring to the academy for all that you have already accomplished. And I also want to welcome you to the work of the academy, because we must not think of becoming a fellow as merely another notch on the CV, but rather as an opportunity to increase the good that you do in society. I want to thank Louis for all that he has done for this academy, his tireless service to it, his passionate commitment to it, backed up by generations of his own family that go back to the very founding of the academy. The founders of the nation saw the need for such an institution and brought together people like Louis's great-great-great-great-grandfather and others of the founders of the nation to serve it. I'm sure if those founders were to visit us today and to see the state of the national life, they would be more persuaded than ever that the Academy is something that the nation needs more now than it has ever needed it. This is the one place that brings together the highest standards of intellectual and artistic accomplishment in an environment where ideas can be freely exchanged and vigorously exchanged. The country needs such a forum. It needs the best of its intellectual and artistic talent to be committed to making the national life better. That's the enterprise in which you join us now, and I look forward very much to being a part of it with you. And now, by authority conveyed to the Academy in 1780 by the General Court of the State of Massachusetts Bay, I hereby declare the 1,999th stated meeting and induction ceremony to come to order.